गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, नमस्कार. सो दोज हु आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल प्लीज सब्सक्राइब, एंड दोज हु आर नॉट येस्टरडे सो लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस अगेन. आई एम मिसेस राधिका कुलकर्णी, डॉटर ऑफ देवयानी खेडकर. सो एक्चुअली माई मॉम इज नॉट फीलिंग वेल, सो आई एम टेकिंग लेक्चर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ हर. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू टूडे. सो टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दी अल्जेब्रा. इन दैट आई विल सी दी चैप्टर नंबर 7, दैट इज स्टैटिस्टिक्स. In that we are going to see what is mean, definition of mean, and with example we will explain what is mean. So let's see what is mean. So how to find mean? So before that I'll explain what is the definition of mean. So I have written the definition here. The average of a given number is called arithmetic mean or simply mean of the given numbers. So the average word, you already are aware of about this word, that is average. So average you have heard in previous standard as well, how to find the average. So average of a number, so the same way we have to find out what is arithmetic mean. It is simply finding the average of the given numbers, and that we call here as arithmetic mean or mean. So let's see the formula of mean. The sum of all the observations in the data divided by total number of observations. So sum, here we have to add all the, sum is add all the observations, that is numbers, series of numbers, divided by total number of observations. So let's see. For example, if x1, x2, x3 up to xn, these are what? N number of observations. So n number of observations in the data. So what we have to do? Add those, divided by, it is total number of observations. Then, so let's find what is mean. Mean is represented by x bar. Please note, this is very important. So it is given by x bar is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 till xn. So the formula is sum of all the observations. So these are all observations. So I am adding this till xn divided by total number of observations. So total number is till n. So here this sign is summation. What we call is sigma. So nothing but summation means adding. So adding all the x's. So this is x divided by total number of observations, that is n. So this we have, this is the formula. X bar is equal to summation of x divided by n. Summation of x means you are adding all the x1, x2 up to xn divided by total number of n. Okay, so I hope this is clear definition. So let's move with the example, actual example. So if the example will be given in the exercise, like find the mean of, these numbers are given. So these numbers are nothing but the x's. This is x1, this is x1, this is x2, this is x3, and so on. So these are the numbers which are given. So now we have to find the mean. Mean is represented by x bar is equal to, we are adding this x1 plus x2, x3, 4 and x5 divided by total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the total. So now adding all this, we'll get 120 divided by 5. So we got 24. So what is mean? Mean, that is x bar is equal to 24. So this way we have to find out mean. I hope mean is clear to all. Okay, so let's proceed with the median concept. First, we have seen what is mean. Mean is nothing but average of sum of all the observations in the data divided by total number of n. Okay, so now let's see what is median. So I have written the definition here. I'll read out the definition. The scores are arranged in ascending or descending. This is very important. Ascending or descending. The scores are arranged in ascending or descending. The number appearing exactly at the middle position in this order is known as median of the observation. Again, I'll read out. Scores are nothing but the numbers. So the scores are arranged in ascending or descending. So this is the first state. The number appearing exactly at the middle position in this order is known as median of the observation. So let's see. I have split in two cases, even and odd. So let's see what is even and odd here. For example, I'll explain the definition over first. So example is like, if there is number of series like 10, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we have to count how many numbers are there. So if in the example there are 4 numbers, that means it is even. If in the example there are 5 numbers, that means it is odd. So if it is even, we have to follow this. If it is odd, we have to follow this. So let's see what is even and odd in depth. Okay. So if the number given in the problem is even, numbers, total number. So the median is the average of the middle two numbers. If the case is even, median is the average of middle two numbers. Okay. So what exactly it means? I have written the example here. Find the median. The example will be given like this. Find the median of below data. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 6. Total count is 6 numbers are given. That means it is even. So we have to follow this two. So median is the average of the middle two numbers. But before this, what we have to do, what the definition says, we have to arrange it in ascending or descending order. So this is given first. Either we can arrange these numbers in ascending order or descending order, whatever is easier for you. So I have arranged these numbers in ascending order. So from this, 15 is the lowest one. So 15, then 20, 30, 40, 55 and 60. So you have to arrange this. So you are following this state. Now, what the even definition says, median is the average of middle two numbers. Once I have written the series in ascending order, what are you get? It is the average of middle two numbers. So which are the middle two numbers? 1, 2, in this example, it is very easy to find middle two numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the two middle numbers. Okay, so it is the average of middle two numbers. So average is what? Average, you know how to find out average. Average of middle two numbers, that is 30 plus 40 divided by 2. It is 70 divided by 2. It is 35. Okay, so here the median. Therefore, the median is 35. Okay, so example was case of even numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are 6 numbers, which is even. So if the numbers are even, then median is the average of middle two numbers. So we have found out what are before that. Following to this, we have to arrange the numbers in ascending and descending. So what I have done, I have arranged all these number in ascending order. And then we have to find out the middle numbers and take the average of these two middle numbers and you will get the median. So this was the easier one. If the example here, in this example there were 6 numbers, but if the example contains of total like 120 or 130 numbers, like 1, 2, 3, 4, or 10, 15, 16, 20. Now this number is like 130, till 130. So in that case, how will you find out which are the two middle numbers? So suppose here it was total number was 6. So now if, for example, the numbers are given 130. Suppose 130 number. The example consists of 130 numbers. So how will you find out the middle two terms? Will you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? No, that is very difficult. So, if 130 are the numbers, what you have to do? 130 divided by, what you have to find out?
average so divided by 2 is equal to 65. So 65 is the first number and the next number is 66. So these are the two middle numbers. So 65th is the term, is the observation, and 66th is the observation. So this is the trick how to find out the two middle numbers in the given example. So hope you understand what is median through this example. Okay, so the second case is odd. If the example given has odd numbers, here it was even number, count was 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now the example consists of odd numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So again, follow the first step. What is the first step? Here, don't directly jump to find out the median. First, you need to write down the series in ascending or descending order. This is very common mistake. So please keep this in mind. First, you need to arrange the series. So I arrange this in ascending order. So the ascending order is 5, then 10, then 12, 15, and 20. Okay, I have arranged this in ascending order. So that what this case says, the number appearing exactly in the middle position. So the number appearing exactly in the middle position. So here it is very simple because the numbers are odd number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5, the middle term is, this is one group and this is other group. So this is the middle term which is in the exact middle position. So here the median is 12. I hope it is understood. Okay, so let's proceed with the third concept, which is known as mode. So how to find a mode? Before that, let's see what is the definition of mode. Mode is the value of observations which occur frequently. Mode is the value of observations which occur more frequently. Okay, and or else you can say observation with the maximum frequency. So what exactly it means, that suppose numbers are given. In example, the numbers are given. So the numbers, suppose the numbers can repeat. So how many times the number is repeated, and that number is called as a mode. So let's see with the example. Example is, suppose marks obtained by 8 students are given. We have to find the mode. What is given? Marks obtained by students, 8 students. So these are nothing but marks. And how many students? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 students have obtained this, first, second, third. So what we need to find out, what is mode? So in this mode, while finding mode, what we need to do? Okay, so the problem says marks obtained by 8 students. So what, there are two actually parameters given here. So first is marks obtained by students, and the other one is the frequency. Okay, so in this way you need to make the tabular form. Okay, so marks obtained by the students. So first is, actually what you can do, you can again arrange this series in the ascending or descending order if you want. Else you can directly go by sequence. So for what I'll do, marks obtained by students. So 35, I'll write it here, versus 35. So I'll count here, 35. How many times, frequency is nothing but how many times this mark, this number is repeating in the problem. So what I'll do, I'll count 1 and 2. So 35, this is my first term, it is repeating twice. 1 and 2. So what is the frequency of this 35? It is 2. Okay. Okay. So what I was saying that 35 is the first term and it has repeated twice in this series. So before that, actually in previous concept we have seen arranging the numbers in ascending or descending order. So that was our mind till now. So what we will follow the same here. Let's not start with 35. What we'll do, arrange this series in ascending order. So let's see what is the ascending order. So ascending order is, first is 13, then it is 35, then 50, 60 and 70. 13, 35, 50, 60 and 70. So this is the ascending order. First we have done in arrange the numbers in ascending order. After that, we are counting the frequency. That is how many times this number will repeat. So 13. 13 is the number. So in this problem, 13 is repeated only one. So what I'll do? I'll write the marks here. 13. 1, 3. It is repeated only one. In this series, 13 has only number or frequency count is 1. That's it. Now next number is 35. 35, if you'll count, it has repeated twice. So for 35, it is 2. Next number is 50. So 50 is repeated only once. So 50 is repeated once. Repeated in the sense, the frequency. Okay, now next number is 16. 16 is thrice, repeated thrice. So frequency of 60 is 3. Next number is 17. So 17, again the frequency is just 1. Only it has arrived once. So only one student has scored 70. So it is 1. So now in this way we have written it in table format. So this is marks obtained by the students. These are the marks and number of students are 8. And we have to find out how many times this number is repeated, that is frequency. So what I have done, I have first written this example in ascending order. So we got this. After writing in ascending order, we have written the first term, the frequency of the first term. So referring to the example, 13 is repeated once. So 1 is the frequency. 35 is repeated twice. In this example, 35 is repeated twice. So the frequency is 2. This way we have found out the frequency of all these 5 terms. So here, what is the mode then? Mode is the value of observations which occur frequently. Value of. Okay. Not this. It is a value of observations. So this is the frequency. What is the value? Maximum frequency. So what is the value of this frequency? This is 60. So mode is 60. Please understand, we need to write mode as a value of observations, not the frequency. So whatever is the highest frequency, the value of that highest frequency will be the mode. So in this example, mode is 60. I hope you understand what is mode and how to find out mode. So in this entire video, we have covered the concepts of mean, median, mode with definitions and with examples. And hope you have understood all the concepts. Those who are new to this channel, please do subscribe, like and comment. It is very much important for you as well, so that you will get this entire data on the top of the YouTube. Please do subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you all.